Hi, guys. I hope you all had a great week. I have a question for you. Who loves you more than anyone else ever could? If you answer God, then you'd be right. The Bible says that God is love. He doesn't just have love, He is love. He loves us no matter what, even when we aren't very lovable. The Bible says that nothing can separate us from His love. God will never, ever stop loving us. So let's jump into our lesson and learn more about the amazing love of God.
He's the chosen one, He's the champion, the winner for all time. With me to the end, Jesus is my friend, He's always by my side. Anything I face, He will be my strength.
Thanks, babe.
All right, shout it out. Sing, dance, joy.
There's Thanks, babe.
Dancing with the hope of heaven, where all my fears fade to gray.
Put those hands together. Yeah. Everyone, it's time for the memory verse. So get up on your feet. This first time, I'll say it and you watch. The second time, I'll say it and you repeat after me. And the third time, we'll all say it together. If you're ready, put your thinking cap on. All right, this first time, I'll say it and you watch. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, and whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8. Okay, everyone, this time you're gonna repeat after me. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8. Great job, you guys. All right, this time we're all gonna say it together. Here we go. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8. Great job, you guys. Hey, keep practicing that memory verse and we'll see you next time.
Wasn't that a great memory verse?
It was so awesome. I think everyone should practice that memory verse at home.
For sure. And that leads us to our main point for today. It's I can know God's love.
Really? How do I know that?
Well, luckily, my friend Jeremy's about to tell us all about it. Check it out.
We believe that God made you and me. We believe He is the loving creator of everything. He created all things out of nothing simply by His word. How amazing is that? Now get this, there is one true God, but He exists in three persons. The three persons are the Father, the Son, who is Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. They are all equal in power and glory. And the way we can learn more about how Jesus loves us and how we can obey and follow him is all found in this incredible book called the Bible. Now, this is quite a big book, but to help you understand, the Bible is the Word of God, meaning that God used men by His Spirit to write everything in this book. The Bible, God's Word, is perfect. You can trust what it says. Now, it's not a book like other books. You don't have to start at the beginning. You can. However, the Bible is a collection of many books written over a long period of time. But all together, they tell one story that leads us to Jesus. It is one super cool narrative about how God has chosen humanity, that's us, as His partners to look and rule over this amazing world. It's about how we messed up by something called sin and ruined our relationship with Him, and how God offers a way to bring us back into His family through His Son, Jesus. He loves us so much, and He wants everyone to be His son and daughter. The cool thing is that God still uses His Word to speak to us all the time. And once you learn how to read the Bible, you'll notice that His Word can transform how you live and how you think about everything. The Bible defines us and tells us who we are. It gives us incredible promises about God, promises about what God has done for us and will do in the future. He wants us to glorify and enjoy our relationship with Him. He wants to be our best friend, because apart from Him, we can do nothing. But in His presence, we will experience the fullness of joy and eternal life.
There's a song coming up in my soul, Lord, in my soul.
What's up?
What's up? What's up?
That's a lot of what's ups.
I know, I felt it, man. My name is Jeremy.
And I'm Jay. And you know, man, I got a lot on my mind today.
Really? What do you have on your mind?
I just got a lot on my mind. I really don't even know where to begin.
Okay, well, just hold on. We'll get to it in a second. But let me finish our episode intro, because a good episode always has a good intro.
Okay, you're right.
So, what are we talking about today, you might ask? I'll tell you. Today's the last day in this series that we're going to talk about the Gospel of John. And this book is all about Jesus' life here on earth.
You're right, man. It tells us about miracles He performed, conversations He had with friends He made along the way. I just really love this book because it tells us who Jesus truly is.
That's right. And we've got some tips for you during this series and for future series.
So tip number one.
Bring your Bible to church every Sunday. Because we're not just going to read off the screen. We're going to learn how to find the scriptures in our Bibles and read the Word all together.
That's awesome, man. Now, tip number two, bring your listening ears.
Move over, because I got some good listening ears today.
Bro, what even is that?
So I know this is a thing, but these are my special ears for this special occasion.
I think you need to move them off your head.
No. I have different ears for every occasion.
Your ears are fine.
No, I'm trying to milk this thing as long as I can.
No, yeah. Bro, that's not going to happen.
Okay.
I've told you once. We're not
okay, just
again.
Go on.
Anyways. Okay. We're gonna learn a lot this series.
So you're not gonna...
What, is that a dog?
It was my cow.
Your cow?
Yeah.
You own a cow?
I'm surprised you weren't like, all right,
let's get back to the show. Yeah. You are out of control.
Okay.
That's your show. You're not gonna wanna miss a thing.
That's right. And you never know what's gonna happen on this show. That's a lot of fun.
Dance is awesome, man. Yeah, you ever been in a dance crew?
I mean, I tried out for a few.
I remember I was
almost
in
the
dance
made
crew.
It into one or two of them.
Man,
they said I wasn't cool enough. But
what's Jay thinking about?
It was my big night. I had a solo, and it was my time to shine. I practiced and practiced, and I was at the top of my game. I was ready to leave it all on the dance floor. But something tragic happened. I was landing my triple backflip and something went wrong. The crowd panicked, and my teacher ran onto stage, but it was too late. Sure, nothing was broken, except my pride. All the dancers laughed at me, and I was so embarrassed that I ran. I kept thinking, I have to run as fast as I can. I had to get out of there. So there I went. I found myself at home. I drowned my broken dreams in Rocky Road and vowed I would never compete again. And thus ends my career as a dancer. Well, man, that's it. That's my story of my dance crew.
There's no way. Like, you loved it. How could you have stopped being in the dance crew?
You know, Jeremy, I really don't want to talk about it. It really hurt me when all my friends laughed at me. I mean, how could they do that? They were all my friends.
I'm sorry, man. Like, I know how that feels when your friends hurt you. You know what? Can I pray for you?
What? Really? Like, right now?
I mean, why not?
I guess. I mean, that's fine.
Okay. God, I just thank you for Jay, and I thank you for everything you've done in his life, that he went through a really hard situation. And I know how it feels, that sometimes you have friends in your life and they don't do what a good friend should do. But I thank you that you love Jay, and Jay really shows the love that you offer to all of us. And he didn't pay back the friends like you wanted to. He showed them your love, because that's the greatest commandment you give us, Lord, to love. And I thank you that you encourage Jay right now, that he sees himself like you see him, and he lives out your love even more every day. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Wow, Jeremy. Thank you for praying with me, man. You're such a good friend. I've never had anyone pray with me like that. I really appreciate it.
Of course, man. Well, I think you made the right decision not to hurt the people back who hurt you. It had to be hard, but Jesus knew what it was like to experience that, that pain, that disappointment. He was even hurt by the people he cared about, too. He was constantly looking out for others, even up until the day before he died on the cross. He was praying over and caring for his disciples.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, in John 17, not only did he pray for his disciples, he said a prayer for us, like me and you. He's praying over us.
Wait, what? What? Jesus was praying for me? Why did he do that?
Yeah, so Jesus prays for us to show how much he cares about you and me. Jesus knew we'd face tough times, just like his disciples did, but we can experience his love through his prayers. And that's what today's main point is. I can know God's love.
Wow. Man, I really want to experience some more of God's love. Can we read Jesus' prayer, Jeremy?
Of course, man. Now, we're going to break this prayer up into a few pieces because it's actually a whole chapter long.
Man, that must be a really good prayer.
It is. Hey, can you grab your Bible real quick?
Yeah, man, I sure can.
So let's get started in John 17.
All right, let me find it.
I'll give a little backstory while you're getting there. This prayer spoken by Jesus took place with his disciples the night before he would be crucified. Even though he was about to experience an agonizing death, he was actually thinking about them and us. Jesus was concerned about his disciples and wanted to make sure that they were prepared for what was about to happen. So how about you start in John 17, 9 and go to 13, okay?
Awesome, got it. My prayer is not for the world, but for those you have given me, because they belong to you. All who are mine belong to you, and you have given them to me, so they bring me glory. Now I'm departing from the world. They are staying in this world, but I am coming to you. Holy Father, you have given me your name. Now protect them by the power of your name so that they will be united just as we are. During my time here, I protected them by the power of the name you gave me. I guarded them so that not one was lost except the one headed for destruction, as the scriptures foretold. Now I am coming to you. I told them many things while I was with them in this world, so they would be filled with my joy.
Wow. And all this prayer spoken by Jesus wasn't just for the disciples. It was for you and me, Jay.
Really? So you're saying Jesus prays for me and cares for me?
Yeah, so much. God not only wants you to be protected, but he also wants to help us be unified and have joy, all for his glory.
You know, Jeremy, this prayer kind of reminds me of what you prayed over me earlier. What did Jesus mean when he prayed for unity?
Well, another version reads that Jesus prayed that they all may be one. So to be united simply means no matter our skin color, where we come from, what we do, we are all equal and loved, just as Jesus and the Father are one. It blesses God's heart when we are unified with all of his children. No matter if they love and know God or not, we should do our best to truly care and love each other. And this is a great way to show people the love of God. When the world may be filled with hate, arguments, and evil, we as the church should love and care for one another. And by doing this, we are showing the love of Jesus everywhere we go.
So you're saying when we do this and we live a life different than the world, others will see something truly different about us?
Exactly. And that thing that is different about us is that Jesus lives within our hearts. And that's ultimately what gives us joy, the love of Jesus. And no matter what happens in this world, we read in the scripture that Jesus always promises to be with us.
Man, I really love that. I can't believe how much Jesus, the Son of God, cares for me.
He really does, man. Jesus wants to be close to us and to comfort you in your times of trouble. Jesus was going to experience the worst death and probably was filled with questions and possibly even fear, but he chose to put others first. So if you're ever in a situation where you've lost a friend or maybe you're being picked on at school or things just didn't work out like you planned, Jesus is right there. He wants to show you how much he loves you and how much he cares for you.
I'm so glad you told us that, Jeremy. I want to experience the love of God like that. Can you help me break it down and make it simpler to understand how?
I think we can do that. But first, let's finish up reading this chapter and see if we can find some clues on how to know God's love.
That's a great plan, man. Pull out your Bible and find John chapter 17 once more. You're going to be reading from John chapter 17, verses 22 through 26 with your leader.
We'll see you in a little bit.
See you there.
You did. Because you just said, oh, hey.
Yeah, my bad. You're right. I guess you're right. Let's just go.
So, after reading over all the scriptures in John 17, we think we found four ways that will help us know and experience God's love for us. The first takeaway is that I can know God's love through unity.
That's exactly right, man. When we love one another, we can not only show God's love, but we can experience it. Our second takeaway is so simple. It's that I can know God's love through prayer. When I pray to God, I can get to know him and get close to him. When I am close to him in his heart, I will always know the love of the Father.
And none of this is possible without knowing our third takeaway. I can know God's love through a relationship with Jesus. Because Jesus died on the cross for our sins, our relationship with God was restored. Jesus was without sin and took on all of the sins of the world so that we could be in a relationship with God.
Which is the best news ever.
Yeah.
Because of what Jesus did, I can know God's love.
Dude, that's the best news ever. Today's been such a good day, right?
Yeah, man. I can't wait to tell my friends and family all I learned today.
That's awesome. And don't forget, Jesus loves you, prays for you, and he's always with you. Jesus' death on the cross is the ultimate act of love.
That's awesome, man. Thanks for learning with us today. We'll see you real soon.
So, we know that God's love just keeps going and going and going and going. Well, I think you get the point. It never ends and never goes away. So let's pray this prayer together. Jesus, thank you for your love that's always with me and will never ever let me down. Help me show your love to those around me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Have a great week, and I'll see you soon.